Welcome to the TPC Desktop video series on using COGO. In this video, we'll look at using the COGO Summary button. I've opened up the Learn COGO sample file. You'll find it in your sample folder. And I've added some points down here in the southeast corner. Let's go ahead and look at those. I'll zoom in. And we can see that I've added point 30 just east of the lot line from 2 to 3. Let's put the cursor over 30. It can be over the label or the symbol, either one, and right click. And you see there's a COGO option here. It brings up all the COGO tools available from the drawing view here. And I want the offset to line. Traverse PC opens the offset to line dialog, and it uses the point that I selected 30 as the point to offset from. I want to use the little chevron button up here to select this lot line from 2 to 3. So I click the chevron, it highlights in a blue. I come back to the drawing now, and if I put the cursor over that lot line, I get a tooltip, and I left click to select the line from 3 to 2. Traverse BC said I was closer to the point 3 when I selected it, so it uses that as the from. It doesn't really matter in this particular computation whether we go from 2 to 3 or 3 to 2. But notice Traverse BC now has computed all of the offset information. I know that I'm 36.54 feet. Here's the bearing. I know I'm left of the line from 3 to 2. And I know that the point that it computed online is 34.13 feet from the beginning of the line at 3. Let's go ahead and give that a point label. I'm going to call it point 30 OFS. I'm going to save it and plot it, just so you can see it on the line here. Now, let's take a look at the summary that Traverse PC creates for us based on the information in this dialog. So we're going to hit the summary button. Traverse PC is going to open the current report, put a little space between whatever was in the report previously, and then it's going to generate the report for us. And I want us just to stop and take a look at this for a moment. Notice that we started a new section in the report with the double brackets. It uses the information at the top of the dialog, offset to line, grid bearing, grid distance, and feet as the title. And then it gives us the date and time and the distance and direction types that were used in this COGO computation. Then I look for the given section and the computed section. The given section shows me what I started with. I wanted a perpendicular offset to the line, which is a tangent from 2 to 3, so I get the information on the tangent. I'm offsetting from point 30, so I get the information on point 30. Then Traverse PC computed for me the offset from 30, and here's that offset information. It also computed a point on line, 30 OFS, and here's the information on that point, and that's where we would find then our distance from start of line to the point on line being 34.13 feet. This information is now part of the survey. It's stored in this particular report, which is the current report for this survey. If I were to close out this report, I can open it back up anytime by choosing the report view. And Traverse PC simply opens the report and shows me where I left off. Now, reports are word processing files, so I can add additional information to this. It's a great way to keep track of the work I'm doing inside of a survey. And I have a record now of how I computed this 0.30 OFS and the information about 0.30 to this lot line from 3 to 2. We just did a grid COGO computation for offset to line. Now let's take a look at doing the same computation geodetically. If we open the task manager and look at the survey information, we can see that this coordinate reference system for this survey is NAD 83, Oregon South. So we can quite easily come back and in the same COGO dialog, change our options to geodetic. Let's pull down the direction type and choose true bearing based on mean course convergence. And for the distance type, let's choose geodetic distance at project elevation of 5,000 feet. So if we look at the top of the dialog now, Traverse BC is telling us that we're now using true bearing and geodetic distance. And if we look at our intermediate computations, we're going to see that that has changed also. Notice we have a slightly different offset distance now, which we would expect, and a somewhat different offset bearing now. So let's go ahead and choose Summary and see what Traverse BC did here. Traverse BC adds a section now for us that gives us the true bearing and geodetic distance offset summary. Right above it is our original grid summary. So let's take a look at what we have here now in this summary. Right away, Traverse BC tells us this computation was based on geodetic distance at project elevation 5,000 feet using true bearings. So in the given section, we're reporting the given line that we're using, the tangent from 2 to 3. Remember in the grid section up here, that tangent information was 163.50 and north 23.27 east for that tangent. Now, because it's a geodetic distance and direction, it's 163.35 for the distance and north 11.19.33 east for the direction. So a geodetic distance and a geodetic direction, consistent with information that Traverse BC just gave us here for the distance and direction type. We're going to see the same kind of difference when we take a look at the computed information. Remember, in the grid computation, our offset distance was 36.54. Now our offset distance is 36.51, just slightly different. And we'll also see that our bearing to the point on line, 30 OFS, is slightly different also. So we're now looking at a geodetic distance for an offset and a geodetic direction for our bearing to the point on line. We'll also see that our distance from the start of the line has changed somewhat from 34.13 grid distance to 34.1 geodetic distance. So what I wanted to show you here really quickly then is that the summary is going to use whatever distance and direction type you used in that COGO dialog. It's going to report that computation then either based on those grid computations or based on the geodetic computations. And it's pretty explicit in the summary which it's using and how it reports it to you.